Hi, welcome to How to Repair. This video is on how a washing machine door lock works and how to test a door lock or door interlock as they're called in the trade. There are literally hundreds of different types of door interlock fitted to all the manufacturer's washing machines. Understanding how they work will give you a good idea whether you have a faulty door interlock on your machine. Most door locks only have three terminals on them: a live, a neutral, and a common. But on occasions you do get a door lock which has got four terminals. This might be going to an LED to actually show you that the door is open or shut, like this one on the bottom. The problem is, with most modern machines today, the new interlocks only have numbers written on them, and unless you have a wiring diagram, you do not actually know whether it's the live, the neutral, or the common. So we have to actually try to work this out using a meter. On some washing machines, they actually fitted a door interlock which was quite clever. They fitted one with a cable attached to the bottom of it. Now, this cable you were able to pull that would be hidden behind the kickstrip in case of an emergency to open the door and rescue your clothes. The only real check you can do to a door lock outside of the parameters of an electrical field is to actually check the PTC heater. This heats the bimetal strip inside the door lock, which then activates the door switch. On this door lock, I know that the actual terminals for live and neutral are on number 2 and number 3. This is because I have the wiring diagram for this machine. The common is number 4. Now, the problem being is most people would assume that the connections are all the same. The actual live, neutral and common on all door locks are different. On this door lock, for example, it is not on number 2 or 3. It is on number 3 and number 4. As different manufacturers use different suppliers for door locks, you should never assume from the colour of the wiring that it is a live, common or neutral. You should always look clearly at the door lock or the wiring diagram to ascertain whether this is the neutral, live or common. Most modern door locks have plugs that can only be fitted one way. So in other words, the wiring is always correct. So if you are trying to put spade connectors onto an old burnt plug, make sure you know what you're doing. Because not only will you blow the new door interlock that you are trying to fit, you would also do damage to the circuit board. As you can see with this older type door lock, it is clearly marked C, N and L, meaning that the circuit on the right, which I'm testing here, which is intermittent, because I know this door lock is faulty, and that is clearly marked L and N for live and neutral, and I know the common is the one on the left. And as you can see, this door lock, sometimes you're getting a reading and sometimes you don't. I have actually cut this door lock apart to actually show it you working when I wire it up to my test rig. Now, the wire, or the terminal to the left, is the neutral. The one in the middle is our live feed, and the one to the right is our common. As I said earlier, these do vary from machine to machine. So the one on the left here is our neutral, the one on the right is the common, and the one in the middle is the live feed. Now, what actually happens is when the live and neutral heat up the PTC heater, it will heat the bimetal strip, which will then move the mechanical part of the switch, which I will show you in detail in a second. My test box is actually wired up with the switching on the neutral. The live is constantly live, and the yellow goes to a lamp. So as we throw the door switch over, as to simulate the door closed, it will activate the light after the bimetal strip has been heated up. Inside the door lock, there is also a locking pin, which is thrown over as the common is activated. This actually keeps the door locked, and keeps it locked even after the machine has finished for roughly 2 minutes. This is why you can never get into your machine at the end of the cycle straight away. So, the neutral is going to be switched, the live is constant, and then once we push the door lock over to simulate the door being closed, the power will then go through the yellow wire to the lamp, showing that the machine has got a live circuit. As the bimetal strip is heated, it pushes the switch over, but the lamp only comes on if the door was shut. So we're just shutting the door there and the lamp comes on. This is showing that we have now power being allowed to pass from the live to the common to activate the rest of the machine. I will show you in more detail the bimetal strip heating up, and here goes the switch and it throws it over. Now this also activates the pin that locks the door in place. At the end of a wash cycle, even though the machine has finished its cycle, it will not allow you to open the door for roughly about 2 minutes while the bimetal strip cools down. When the bimetal strip has cooled down in 2 minutes, the lamp will go out. While we're waiting for this to cool down, please remember there are links on the left-hand side of this video and also in the description for mobile users. The link at the top will take you through to our shop, where you're able to purchase the door lock for your appliance. Please remember you will need your full model number off the identification plate on the machine. Do not assume that it is the number on the facial panel, as sometimes the numbers do vary. The other two links at the bottom will take you through to the full tutorial for this video, which has extra videos on how to fit door locks and how to open the door that is stuck shut. Please also remember to subscribe to our channel, as that's what keeps us going and able to make this free video for you. You can see the light going out here now. That means that the power has been cut from the feed to the common. But as you can see, the switch has not gone down, which locks the door. As soon as you touch the door handle or press the door release button, it takes the pressure off this switch and it pops back in. One of the common problems when a door lock fails is the plastic inside the lock can distort. This means at the end of a wash cycle, when you come to release the door to get your clothes out, you can't open the door, and this is usually due to the plastic distorting. But you can see how little pressure is needed to release the door. The light has now gone out, so as soon as we touch the door handle, in other words, sliding the slider over here, just to release the pressure off this pin, it pops back into place. Now, if the plastic was distorted, it might not pop back into the mechanism, therefore keeping your machine locked. Behind the back half of this cover, which I've had to keep on for actually making the switch work, is this tip of the points. This makes the electrical contact between the live and the common. And the pin that you can see that goes up and down actually locks the door in place. And as I said, on this door lock, the live is always active when the machine is switched on, but only allows electricity to pass through to the common when the door lock is switched. And there you go. Thanks very much indeed for watching this video. Please remember to support the website, whether you buy the parts through us, subscribe to the channel, or even donate by buying us a beer. Thanks very much indeed for watching this video, and please remember to visit the website. Thanks again.